I'm used to cook it on white fire. I've never done it on a gas, so we're gonna try it together. That's a good sign. Maybe not this one here. All right. So the pan's got to heat pretty well first. And with vegetable oil instead of virgin oil as we're using all the time. So we're gonna pan fry our chicken. So we're gonna make a paella with chicken and seafood. Not too much, just enough. So we're having some fresh squid, some tiger prawn. If you want to make it more luxury, you can have some monkfish or even lobster. And then little frozen prawns. Oops. And some clams, fresh clams. Well, quite lots of seafood you will see time after time. Okay, that seems to be hot. Gonna reduce the gas. All right. So. We start with our chicken, give it a good color. Darling, can you open the door? It won't be too cold. It's all right. That should do. Okay, usually we put one more log of wood to make it faster, but. Maybe another day we do on a white fire. Bon ben, let's wait. So during the time being, we're gonna infuse our saffron into a pan of water. So some people using our powder or filaments. This one is a filament, this is 1 gram. So we're gonna infuse it. For the quantity we are making, we might have need 2 gram. It goes yellow. It's better to do it outside already. You won't have to clean after. That needs more color. It's splashing. Bon ben, let's wait. Yeah, you can cut. Okay, so now we just turn them around to give color on both sides. Ah, it got stuck, that one. That will give some flavor. Yeah. And I forgot to present you. We had, we got two Spanish ladies just arrived. Hey, darling. Hey, look at that. This is Jenny.
Hello. What can I get?
No, nothing.
You just want me in the shop?
Yeah.
Stand here and look for me.
That's it. And the other one will come shortly. Here she comes. This is Julia, the manager of Saveurs.
Hello.
What are you doing with that? Health and safety. Okay. So now the chicken is done, we just remove it and leave a space to cook the vegetables. Okay, that's well colored. Let's leave it on the side. And now, we're gonna give some color in our pan. So we got chopped red pepper, green and yellow. Beautiful color. It might be too fatty. You see, there's too much fat, so I'm gonna empty some somewhere. So we're gonna give some color now. Beautiful color, Rastafari. So we are not gonna cook them too much, just to keep all this suck from the meat. Yeah, the fire still on. Another log of wood. So keep stirring it, otherwise it might burn. You don't have to get a paella pan to make it, just in a pan fry pan, it's enough for 4 people really. It's just for fun to have lots of people doing in this pan. Well, let's leave it. Okay, so the pepper's been cooking for 5 minutes. See, they're a bit color, but not too much. Voilà, a bit color, not too much. On high heat. And now we're gonna pour some tomato. Chopped fresh tomato. Voilà. Ah, Voilà, we need to cook it another 5 minutes to cook the tomato a bit. So now it's been the tomato with pepper has been cooking another 5 minutes. This is pretty roughly cooked. Now we're gonna pour the some chopped garlic and parsley, quite big. Ah. That's enough. And now you can start the smell of everything because of the garlic, parsley. It just pull up all the flavors. Lovely. Okay. So this you don't have to cook it too long now. We're gonna add all our seafood. Okay. So we're gonna put some prawns with the head, everything, more natural. Yeah. Just to give more texture, we're gonna just put some frozen prawns, which you can find everywhere. Then come the, where is my squid? Have you seen my squid? Here he is.
Yeah.
He was hiding. Fresh squid, all chopped in a ring. Lovely. Let's give a little stir. Hello.
Yes.
Where are you eating tonight?
actually, I think we're not eating here. I wish we were. Look at that. Wow. Is that like a paella?
Yeah, it is a paella.
Yeah, it's delicious.
Don't be a monsieur.
Oh, thank you. I get drunk now. Huh? Is that the sangria, is it?
Yeah.
Would be nice to have little pieces of fruit in there. Okay. So we're gonna leave it a little bit to cook. Then will come all the shellfish, clams, and the rice. Hello.
Hi there. Oh wow, it's me.
Thank you. Do you like paella, yeah?
Love any sort of seafood, shellfish, lovely.
Mm.
So what we got in it? We've got
everything, squid, king prawns, you got tiger prawns coming in a minute in there. Yeah, some clams.
Oh god.
Beautiful. Amazing.
Good enough to eat.
Yeah, where are you gonna eat tonight?
Well, we haven't made our mind up yet.
Ah,
staying up the road.
You might change mine, maybe.
Yeah.
I'll make sure it smells good then.
Delicious, thank you.
Very good.
Thank you. Right, so now we're gonna just season a little bit.
Yeah.
And then pour the rice and our saffron water. So, let's season. Do you have the salt, madame? Jobby lovely. Not too much because the seafood is pretty salty already. Okay, splashing everywhere. We're gonna have to do the glasses, I think, the glass. Okay, so let's pour the rice. Actually, we can put our clams as well. Another rice. Good. So it's a long rice, long grain rice. Well, that's 1 kilo already. Let's give a little stir. Should we put more? You have a look. You need to guess the height of your pan as well, because when you're gonna put the liquid, usually one quantity of rice needs 3 quantity of water to cook it well. But here we're just gonna guess. Yeah, a bit more rice. That will be fine. 1.5 kilos. Yeah, you see there is enough rice in there. Yes, it's lovely. Okay. I need to be careful on this side, it's probably burning on this side. Okay. So now we're gonna put our saffron water. The saffron infused. Which is very orange now. And we're gonna cook it gently on a low heat. Okay. Yeah, it should be enough water, so now we're gonna keep an eye. If it needs more water, just add a little bit of water. And yeah, you guess if you need more rice or no. Maybe I'm gonna put just a little bit. Any little holes. Does that smell good? Oh, stop lying. Yeah, that's enough. So we're just gonna let it cook gently. Let's put our tiger prawn on top. And sometimes at this stage, if you can afford or if you got the opportunity, you just cut in half a lobster and push it down in this rice, and it will give an amazing flavor. Voilà. The mussels. So the mussels, you just put them this side down. Like that, they're gonna open in like that and get all the rice inside. So it's gonna make a kind of amuse-bouche with the mussel and rice. So you put them everywhere. Make sure when they're open, they're closed down back, otherwise it means they're dead. This one is good. So this recipe has been my dad teaching me and his dad teaching him. It's a family recipe where we come from. Actually, if I tell you the whole recipe, he might kick my bottom. That smells lovely, no? It's amazing. We are so lucky living by the sea. Got all the fresh seafood. Very lucky to be able to create something like that. Et voilà. Now we're gonna let it cook. And it should be ready in a minute. Non. The chicken, it goes back. Gonna put a little bit more water. Because the water is like nearly finished. Just to steam up a bit everything. And then cover it with tin foil. And everything's gonna steam together and finish to cook. Voilà. But we'll check out in a minute. Okay, so now we just at this stage check how is it like. Yes, it's nearly cooked. But we check the seasoning, still a bit of water. Huh? salt, pepper is fine. If it's missing some, you can put some more now. So maybe we're just gonna make a kind of hole to make all the water going out, all the steam, and leave it like that for a bit longer. All right, so now it might be cooked. Let's have a look. I did remove the meat in between. Yeah, just check if it's not burned. Yeah, it's not burned. That's good. So we're gonna turn off the fire. Let's have a little test and it should be done. Yeah, it's cooked, it's good. It's quite moist, it's got to be moist to keep the rice moist. Yeah. Ah, job done. Just put everything back inside and put the tin foil again on the top, waiting your guests. Et voilà. That's a big one, isn't it? Beautiful. Yeah, the prawns is cooked, everything's fine. And see the mussel? It's just full up with rice. See? So it's great. Voilà. Voilà, all done. Just need to waiting our guest and that's all. Okay, so to dress your dish, to make it nice, just have a lemon, cut it in quarter, then just cut half the skin. And you're gonna understand why. Cut half the skin. And you just stick it in your paella dish like that. When we are gonna remove the tin foil, it's gonna be beautiful. In quarter, half, half, up. Just dressed up your pan. Voilà. Should I finish to cut all around and then we cover it?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah? Ready? Okay. So là, you just present your paella là. Do you want to try, Jules?
Yes, please.
Okay, have a go.
Nice.
If it's not nice, you tell me. Yeah? Check the seasoning as well. So how is it like? Mm. You sure? Mm. Seasoning?
Maybe a little more salt.
Ah, knew that.
That's
no.
Lovely. Ah, it's great.
You bought that from Mark.
Is everything all right, yeah?
Fantastic.
Thank you. Enjoy.
You've got to eat it now, Bethany.
My fault. Mmm. Wow. That is good. Lovely. Yummy. This is yummy, actually. Better than the